whistling. Oh, and there's Barkle trying to start a fight with a person. Oh, check it out, there's the pedophile. You know that guy's a pedophile, right? You can look it up online if you want to see that your boyfriend rapes kids. He's also not supposed to be here and he knows it. That's why I'm being loud enough that he can hear me.
See? I told you. And they always claim to be Pizzagate, they always claim to be Pizza Hut, or Bates Pharmacy. Or this is a new one. So now do you get the idea of why they were always saying that they were Pizza Hut and Bates Pharmacy? It means they masturbate to pizza. It means they like kids. So we're gonna go ahead and get a shot of his girlfriend's license plate. So that way when she goes to file reports, say, oh, he's harassing my innocent boyfriend. And then you go, well, you know he's a pedophile, right? And she goes, yeah, that's a lie. That was all made up. Then you guys will go ahead and have some evidence that she knows. Or he's lying to her. Which, once again, that's highly suspicious when a man is lying to a woman about his Pizzagate affiliation. Let me find my hat. It'll take me a minute. By the way, you see how they started up exactly like I told you to? They would. Exactly like I told you they would. Somewhere. I know you're still recording. Oh, there you are. Let's go get that license plate. And let's make the door loud so in case they want to start a fight. And we're going to do it right in front of Starkle while she's sitting there. So that way when she does make a report, it will only accurately reflect mine. State plates too, like I thought. It says Treasure State, Montana, 475305B. But their footprints come from here. So let's see if we can track it back to their car. Though I could have swore I saw him getting out of that one. Footprints come from here. And here's another car missing its front license plate. And its license plate is... Credit Auto Sales. No license plate. Yep. This is what I'm talking about. Oh, and there's a red car. Let's see if this is for us. I don't see any other familiars. We'll go ahead and head back the other direction after I point that out.
And we'll go ahead and keep you running as we walk past back by. So that way if Starkle tries to do a forced interaction, the same lady who used to kidnap and traffic me for pedophilia as I walk right past her nonchalantly, then you'll know. And there's the footprints. As you see, there's none coming from this car. They came from before there, and one of them's wearing cleats. Actually, while we're here, let's get the grin. The grin's the best part. Here we go. So that way in a couple months, when it happens, you won't feel sorry for her. Oh yeah, and tell Shirley I said hi. You see? And now I'm going to keep track on Bilmo's door, so that way you can see that his son is staying the night here while she watches. Now from inside, we're going to get that grin, so that way you guys see that this drama over harassing somebody that she used to kidnap and try to murder is what she enjoys. So when you guys in the future say, "Oh, the poor pedophiles, they're sick too, somebody did it to them," remember, they enjoy this. That's like saying somebody had sex with your mom and you were born, so you have to go and rape people. It doesn't make any sense. There's people who have relationships and children, and there's rapists. These are rapists. Yep, she's watching right at the window right now. And remember, they only brought Star in here again once they couldn't get my mom in the building. And seriously, they're going to murder this bitch because of what she knows about them, because she can turn evidence and witness to you, Mr. Bluefed. That is why they're going to kill her. Make no mistake, it isn't because she's loyal, it isn't because she's good. They're gonna kill her because of the fact that she is participating to a point to where she can be found out. And here is Dead Leaves meeting up with her. Why this is important is because then when I tell you that right now, they have had Justin inseminate this woman, then had her give the semen to Skunk, then had them give it to Star, then had Star put it in this woman's kid. So when you know that that's the way that it worked, you won't feel bad. Now I want you to watch them gaslighting now. This is them trading information to each other. These are two female pedophiles that are so confident that they're never going to be caught that they straight up do it to my face, knowing that I'm an adult who has made a charge against them. That's how confident they are, that the ring runs everything. So, I want to keep getting this on film. I want to keep filming that this was this Northern CSL place's continual attempt to try to create a building that they can mass rape and kill kids in. And if I hadn't been being a stick and other people being a stick on their side, and some of the women reporting that they straight killed their kid, it wouldn't have even come this far. I would have already been a statistic. So now I'll record for as much time as I got to show you how long these two are gonna sit in front of my window, so that way when they go to make reports and complaints,
and they try to hold those up in court, you can throw the book at them. Because this is a massive misuse of resources. Not one of them has a disability. Their only disability is that they kidnap, rape, and kill other people's kids. That's their disability. This one does it to her own kid. See, them putting semen in this little girl is to cover up that Poland's actually the one that rapes this little girl. Fact. I know, because I even filmed it for you, the way that he was whistling at her for days, playing with her hair, tickling her chin, and then all of a sudden she wasn't happy anymore. Then Poland was really happy whistling at me every day, and this girl suddenly had money for booze and partying and shit. Yeah. Yeah. Poland paid money to get a raper kid. This is what's going on here. And a moment ago when I had to go outside, you should have seen how big of a grin on her face, like, ha 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 ha, I got you. Don't you remember when I used to kidnap and rape you when you were a kid? Ha 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 ha. When I used to have my friends go like 10 dudes deep on you? Ha 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 ha. See, some guys, they get so emasculated by living through this that they either end up Faglix, the big gay child molester, or people like Fart that work for the cult because they're too weak to resist it. Though Fart doesn't really exactly, he's a perpetrator, so no, he doesn't really fit there. What's a good example of someone's too weak to resist? You know, I haven't found very many of those. They're pretty much black and white about it. I mean, their initiations are sodomy and child rape. They're pretty black and white about it. Oh, I'm gonna get the look on the smile on her face too, to show you that she's never been this happy before. She's so fucking happy right now. And here's the cop. There he is. They called him because they saw me outside, and there he is again. Undeniable, wearing the same fucking clothes. It's the same dude. So this is a serial sexual predator. And this is Jason Eshte, the cop that protects her to make sure that she can continue to kidnap and rape kids for his order. Yep, yep. And if it's not Jason Eshte, it's his partner that looks a lot like him. And I don't mean Kyle. Kyle's his underling that he butt fucks. This is a different guy. So did you see the way when I went out there, I wanted to point out and get on film that Starkle got on her phone? Once again, I went outside to show you something. One of the members got on their phone, and the same motherfucker shows up. We'll keep doing this for as many roles as we can. I want you to really see that these people are an organized murder, child rape, fraud, and community theft ring. That is what they are. And we're going to post this so that way the world gets to see the big smile on her face when I warned her that I've burned her and that her own cult is coming to kill her. So that way when you hear her little escort prostitute daughter going, "Oh, but my mommy!" You go, was that the same mommy that used to allow dudes to go 10 deep on you and then 10 deep on him, pointing to her boyfriend, and then 10 deep on him, pointing to me? These people are serial pedophiles. They need to be killed. However, the problem is I would rather gone further up the ladder and gotten the people who are responsible for them, which are the very people who are going to kill them. So, remember now, when this woman gets murdered and the police that do her pedophile ring cover it up and make it look like a suicide or a natural occurrence for all four of these people, I want you to remember that the Spokane Police's special unit cops and other federalized cops are the serial predators, and these are the people they get to do their dirty work while their other Luciferian, Fabian, and etc. society members in the mental health system recruit more people like them on the basis of what their mental illness is. This lady was recruited because she has the same biometrics as my mom. They recruited her so they could steal and kidnap me, while having an ID of my mother's from the garbage can that Melanie stole and then gave to this woman so that way she could claim to be my mom and say I was just a problem child. And so I had to act up, I had to go along with it, because otherwise then she would say that she was my mom and then sign me to a mental health facility where I would have been kept until I was 18. With my mom's signature, then them saying, well, she's crazy too, and we already got her signature, so it doesn't matter. That was their fucking plan. And that's why I ran from that field trip, and that's why all that weird shit happened. And that was not the only field trip they attacked me on, and shit, one of them they permanently disabled me and killed me on. So I'm pretty sure you know that if I didn't sue the school I was with, and I didn't sue the lady personally, and I didn't sue the people around, that there was more going on. And what was going on is they were trying to kill me. So when I see CNN going, Pizzagate's fake news, fucking CNN is Pizzagate. So they'll probably be out here for an hour, so I'll annotate when they actually do go in. So that way you see the way that this woman is acting as an informant, sitting on my place for the very cops that are going to kill her.